Probably aft. Give you a little bit of details here. The flight deck's 898 feet long. The catapults, which are right here and over on that side, are about 200 feet long. The hydraulic catapults that Hornet had will put an aircraft in the air from zero to about 130 in about 8 seconds. Nowadays, the Nimitz-class carriers will launch a F-14, which is about 40,000 pounds, from 0 to 160 miles an hour in about 5 seconds. The new FA-18 Super Hornets, what they nicknamed the Rhinos, have autopilot launch because the pilots are browning out at the end of the stroke, meaning the blood is pouring out of their brains, so they're starting to fade out. They're getting tunnel vision, so basically the plane flies itself off the deck until the pilot's fully conscious and feels capable of flying the plane.
Oh my Lord.
I can go for that.
Yeah, all they do, the last thing they do right here is they go through the checks. The deck crew goes through the checks. The lead deckhand will salute the pilot. The pilot will salute back. He doesn't grab the stick. He grabs two handrails up here. And he's just holding on to the roller coaster ride.
The ultimate.
For the New Horizons group, we're going to go down to, as you can imagine, there's several compartments that don't accommodate 25 people. So we're going to split the group just slightly. I'd like the Nysons and the Wrights to team up as one group, and then the Sousas, Martinez's, Julie can go with them, Ann can go with the second group. Did I leave anybody out? And the Minnows can go with the second group.
Ballsbees.
And the Ballsbees. I knew I was leaving people out. Thanks.
Quick question. How fast would this launch, say, a World War II fighter off the...
The World War II fighters actually didn't use the catapults.
They didn't.
If you see this line, this white line right down here in the middle,
if you follow it,
it starts on the port side and drifts right. And what that was, because the propeller's turning counterclockwise, so it wants to drag the plane to the port side. So when the pilots took a running, because the fighters didn't have any bombs on them, so they weren't heavy. They can just take a running start at it. But they had to drift to the right side to counter the propeller trying to drag it to the port side. So this line right here angles to the starboard side to counter the pull of the propeller. Hornet had one CV-8 and CV-12 both had one catapult to start out with. And that was just when the planes launched bombs on them, when they were heavier. The Doolittle Raids, that was the amazing thing about it, was the Doolittle Raiders didn't use the catapults because the B-25s weren't equipped. They were Army Air Corps. Commander Doolittle was the last one from the far end of the ship to take off, and he had the most weaponry. He had the most bombs. If you watch like a documentary on them, they lightened the load as much as they could. They actually literally, sounds like a joke, but literally put broomsticks into the anti-aircraft gunnery wells just to make the Japanese think that they had anti-aircraft guns. But they didn't, because they wanted to lighten the load. So, we're gonna head towards the island. Primary flight control. That's air traffic control for the whole ship. Anything that's around the ship would be under the air boss's control. There would be a group up there. They would control what's in the air, what's on the flight deck. Everybody that works on the flight deck has a different colored jersey on, depending on their job. Just to give you an idea, the red would be ammunition, the brown would be plane handlers or plane captains. The guys up in Pryfly can look down and make sure people are in the right positions. This is a very dangerous area. You got the wind blowing, you got aircraft moving around. So you can't just come up here and stand around. The landing area is at an angle. On another dead reckoning table like was down in Combat Information Center. So the captain or the officer of the deck could walk back here just to see where he was in relationship out at sea. This DRT would have to match up with two others, Tom? Two other?
I don't know what the protocol was.
Two other DRTs, they'd have to communicate every couple hours on the squawk box and give a coordinate of what the DRT is reading, and if any of them were off, then they'd have to pull out a sextant like we have back here in this box and shoot the stars and re-coordinate the DRTs.
Typically you'd need three DRTs to come up with an exact position, because if you're only using two and one was off, you wouldn't know which one was off. So if you're comparing three, typically two would be together and one might wander off. So you could disregard that one as a...
Right. Got another radar scope like down CRC. And back here behind Jeff is a Loran system, long-range navigation. This would be antennas that were positioned around the world at land-based areas, kind of like electrical lighthouses, basically. And the Loran system would pick up each signal, triangulate that signal, and give you an idea of where you were at that point in time. You can see the wiring and the communications area around here. This is also part of the communications. Let's see if I can cover anything else. That's about it back here. Is there a group up forward?
Yeah, there's a group right up
there. Pilot house, obviously.
It would disrupt the lines.
The interior of the pilot house. This was the original area when the ship was first built, and then right behind me was an open patio area, and then later on in 1956 it was enclosed.
And why they enclose it?
So the captain could be out there, more space for communications, and we'll take a look at that.
So who, where would you be actually driving the ship from this?
Well, you'd be steering from there. The helm would be there.
Okay.
This is a communications area down to the engine room. A lot of people see this and they think this is actually changing the engine speed. This is a communications device for communicating with the engine room what the request is from the officer of the deck. When you move this and ring the bell down below, then they see it down in the engine room, and then when they obtain that speed that you requested, then the bell rings back, and you report to the officer of the deck that you're at the requested speed. Helm.